Okay. So good morning everyone. So in this class we are going to start with the relational data model. I know we have discussed the relational data model in the when we were studying the data model. So but we'll be like now today we are in studying a detailed manner this relational data model. Okay. So this relational means, as I told you earlier also, relation means is a it will consist of some rows and columns. So it was first proposed in the year 1970 by Dr. E. F. Cote. So this is a very important question. Like there is like lots of questions asked in the like in any exam, like for interviews also they ask who is the father of relational database, like who first proposed this model. So it is Dr. E. F. Cote. So in his paper in 1970, a relational model for large shared data banks, this communication of the ACM. So it's an ACM journal, so you won't be aware of it, I know, but it's a very high standard. Okay, it was published and he even got the ACM Turing Award for it. Okay, next we know that the first commercial implementation of the relational model became available in the early 1980s. So whatever we are using now, when I was studying BTech, we used to work for this one, like study in Oracle DBMS, Oracle 11G. Now you people are doing in SQL. Same thing, the codes remains the same, okay? But the queries are same, but this environments are different. That is why. Next, this was, though it was proposed in 1970, it was made available for commercial use in the year 1980, and now you know that after that the model has been implemented in large number of commercial systems. Now in relational model, what is a relational model? It represents a database as a collection of relations. So obviously now you are aware that what is a relation? It's a collection of tables. We know there will be a database view, that is why we create a database in our MySQL, and inside that we have the collection of tables. Now a relation looks like a table of values. It typically contains a set of rows. We know the set of rows is known as the tuples. So it's written here. So we are already aware of it because we have used it, right? People have already used it. Now each column has a column header that gives meaning, that gives an indication of the meaning of the data items in that column. Just wait for some time. Yes, sorry for the interruption. Okay. So now this each column has a column header. Okay, that gives an indication what does this data items will contain, and it is known as the attribute. And obviously that attributes will have some data type. Data type, now this data type has some different formats are there. Like this, what do you mean by domain? I'll tell you. This domain of possible meaning, like for a data type, we have different possible collection. Like someone can represent date as like DD, MM, YYY, or it can be represent also in a different way, like YYY, MM, DD. So two sets of combinations, and the various combinations are there, right? So these are known as the domains. So for each data type, there may be several domains. Okay? No? Now this is how an relation looks like. Okay? So this is the student is the name of the table, okay, that's the name of the relation. These are the column values, name, SS, and this is the column header, right? So it is known as the attribute. So by going through this name, column name, we understand that it will contain some name of a person. then SSN, that is the social security number, that it will be the unique identifier number or the primary key, whatever you can say. Then home phone, so it will consist of some phone number, then address. So we are aware that what this attribute will contain by going through this header, and we know these rows are known as tuples. So this is how a normal table relation looks like. Now, what is a domain? So I just mentioned a domain is a set of all possible values that an attribute can take. Okay, like for example, I just gave you mentioned as a date format, right? So it can be YYYY, MMDD format, or you can use different format for this. Okay, so even our phone numbers, like it consists of 14 digit number, it valid in India, but you can also change, like if you want to put 10 digit for mobile number, that will be different. Landline, for landline it is different, for mobile it is different, right? So but each value must be atomic. You can only use only one format. Okay, in any attribute, if you are using the date format, you can either use this one or this one. You cannot use both. Suppose in one row you have used this one, in other row you are using this one. So it is not possible. You can either use any one of the format. Okay, next. Next is a tuple. So tuple, we know it is basically a row, but when we represent normally, so we represent using an angle bracket. So here you can check the example is there. A row in the customer relation is a four tuple. How do we know it? Because it consists of four values are there. This number, this is the address, enter address, and then last is the phone number. So it is called a four tuple as it contains four values. Now how many tuple is there? How many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it is 7 tuple because it contains 7 values. And if you want to represent a single row, then that value you need to put it under this angle bracket. Okay? Now a relation is nothing but a set of such tuples or rows. Don't get confused with the word like tuples. Okay, tuples generally means the rows here. I'm telling you from the very first day. Now relation schema. Now the relation schema, you know the structure. It is denoted basically means the structure of the table. So the schema or description of a relation is denoted by this one. R of A1, A2, AN, where R is the name of the relation and A1, A2 to AN are the attributes. That is the column name. Okay, so here you just see an example. Customer is the name of the table or relation, and customer ID, customer name, address and phone number are the attributes. Okay, now each attribute like customer ID, customer name, it may have different set of values. I mean different domain of values, okay? So we can use, for example, here it is written for customer ID, it is possible that 6-digit numbers is there, or it is also possible the 10-digit. So it totally depends. So there are the domains, but we have to use a fixed one. One on a single one, okay? Atomic. Next. Oh, sorry. Formally in a relation. In a relation schema, it's denoted by like this. Okay, we know that R of A1, A2, AN. So where each attribute AI is the name of a role played by some domain D in the relation. So we know it's the attribute only. So and each attribute is related to domain because it falls under certain domain. D is called the domain of A of I, and it's denoted by, say like this, DOM A of I. Okay, now the term degree or arity of a relation is the number of attribute N of its relation schema. Okay, so if I ask you what is the degree of just let me and have one more. So here, if you check, suppose it was a of 3 was there, don't like, okay, now, okay, n is there, it's good. Okay, now if you want to find the degree of this relation schema, so you can, degree or arity means the same thing, okay? So you will say that the degree of this relation schema is n. Why? Because there are n attributes are there. Similarly, if there were only like the previous example we saw, customer, I saw, right? Let's go back here. Customer ID, customer name, address, phone number. Now, can you tell me what is the degree of this relationship? Anyone, what is the degree of this relationship?
4, ma'am.
Yes, because there are 4 attributes. Okay, next, now a relation state R of the relation. Okay, anyone not clear with the degree of a relationship? Just remember the degree of the degree of the relation is the number of attributes in that relation. Okay, number of attributes means the number of columns. Next, a relation state R of the relation schema, this one, R of A1, A2, AN. Okay, Parth is waiting. So, a relation R, a state R of the relation schema of this one is denoted by small r of capital R and is a set of n tuples. When we use the word state, that means it is related to number of rows, okay, where this small r is equal to this one. So, each n tuple is an ordered set of values. So, t equal to this v1, v2, vn. So, where each vi falls under this one. So, when we, now you will not understand when I'll discuss about it more, then you will probably get to understand more things. Now, when you see such kind of like R, small r of capital R, this capital R mean is also called as the intention of a relation, okay, or a table. And this entire relation is now called the extension of a relation. Okay, this part, if you are not clear, I know it, now it will be clear just up in the next slide. Okay, what does this relation state means? See, in for informal term, we know relation is a is a table, right? Formal is a relation word, relation, and then informal, what is known as table. Attribute, informal is column header. Formal term, domain, and what is the informal term? All possible column values. What are the all the possible values or for an attribute is possible, that is the all possible column values. Tuple, obviously row. Table definition is also known as a schema, right? Schema of a the relation, or normally schema. Now the state I was talking about is basically the populated table. Okay, means after you have inserted all the values, that means it contains all the values, so it is now populated, the table is crowded, so it is the state of a relation. Now we will study some of the constraints, relational model constraints. Basically I think 5 types are there, okay, and out of which you already know one, that is the primary key constant. You also used in the table. So this, what are these constraints? So basically constraints are conditions that hold for all valid relation states. Okay, so there are different types of constraint. First is the domain constraint, then is the next is key constraint, then constraint on null values, entity integrity constraint, and last one is a referential integrity constraint. Now what is the domain constraint? That it specifies that within each tuple the value of each attribute A must be atomic value from domain. Okay, that means, see, suppose we are using as I mentioned, the domain means it consists of different data types. Okay, like for this one, integer, we have short integer, long int, float, double precision and float, double precision float. And then for characters, we have like characters, booleans, fixed length, strings, variable, length strings, etc. And then for date, time, timestamps, and falls under all this date. So these things you should always remember when you are using a particular row. You need to use, if you are using shortened, use any one of them. It's not that in one row you are using shortened, in another row you are using like int, so it is not possible. So you are, that is a constant, you can use only atomic value. Okay, that is only a single value. Atomic means only a single value. Okay, any confusion in this domain constraint?
No,
okay. Moving next is the key constraint. So it's mentioned here, like, all elements of a set are distinct, hence so all the rows in must also be distinct. So that means no two tuples, means no two rows should have the same combination of values for all their attributes. So attributes means, like, we have different columns, okay? So suppose in one row you have given that we have attributes like this one, name, phone number, and age, okay, of a person. So you have in one row you have written XYZ, then phone number maybe something 121, something like that, and then age is 28. Again, that information can't be repeated. Again, you cannot write XYZ 121 and whatever I mentioned, like the age something 20 years or something. So two tuples means two rows cannot have the same value, exact same value. So this is not possible. Okay, this is a constraint. Any confusion? Just remember, you cannot, that is for, this constraint is given that sometimes by mistake, what people do, they write the same information two times. But if there is such a constraint, then it gives an error. When by mistakenly people enters the same data again, same values, then it will give an error. Now, any confusion in this point?
No, ma'am.
Next is constraint on null. Now, constraint on null means that any attribute where you mention that which cannot be null, you cannot leave that attribute as empty. For example, you have a roll number of a person, okay? So, for that, you cannot have a name as a null value. Name cannot be null, right? So, some attributes can be left null. Suppose age or salary, wherever it is not applicable, you can keep it null. But wherever you mention the constant not null, then this value cannot have the, can, if you leave empty, then it will show an error. Okay, so just try whenever you create a table. I think last day you people created, but you have created like for the you have used the data type like I think ename, sorry, no, student, you have created S name, bear care, and then the size of the this one, then just add a one more constraint to it, not null. Okay, in that case, if you leave that like tuple, when you enter the value, insert the values, if you leave that tuple empty, it will give an error. For example, last time you were entering the phone numbers, and phone numbers for some of the people were left empty. Okay, but this time, because that was not a constant was mentioned, that phone number can, but in, if you don't mention not null, that means you can leave that place empty. But if you give not null constant, that means you cannot keep the phone number as empty. Okay, so this is the constraint on null. The again we have now this one entity. Yes, any confusion? Any confusion? Not null constraint?
Ma'am.
Yes. Tell me.
Ma'am, we can't write null because at that time at empty spaces I have written null because when the tables are created, the expressions are converted into null only.
No. You cannot write null. True. That is the default value is null. That is why you need to write not null. N-O-T. That is why you need to write not null.
Okay.
Not null constraint. Okay. So So constants or null? So you have to write this one, not
okay.
null.
Okay.
Okay. When you write this, see, for phone number, you whatever assignment that day I gave you, like was the phone number of some people were left blank. Okay. But this time, when you use the, and it worked properly whenever you use the query. But this time, if you use a constant like not null, then you if you keep that phone number place empty, then it will show an error. Okay, because a constant is generally given, that's why. But you need to mention it. Next is the entity integrity constraint. So, entity integrity constraint is basically the primary key constraint. Primary key constant. That means the first is that the primary no primary key can have a null value, because your primary key is the unique identifying factor in the table. Okay, so that is why it is not possible for the primary key to be empty. You need to enter some value. Okay. Next, again, like primary key values are again used to identify the individual tuples. As I told you, right, if you want to differentiate each row, we differentiate using the primary key. So that is why we cannot keep it like that is why it needs to be different also, and which is a unique identifying factor. So if primary key has several attributes, null is not allowed in any of this case. Okay, primary key is like null is not allowed. You cannot like keep it null, empty, and also duplicate is not allowed. So that is the primary key constant, that you cannot keep it empty. So clear till this point? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sure. Now comes the last constraint, the referential integrity constraint. Now this. What does this referential integrity means? That referential integrity involves two relations. So when two relations mean, it will consist of two tables. Suppose that table is one is the referencing relation and the reference relation. Now let me give you an example. Okay, for two tables, we have an employee table and we have a department table. Okay, so employee table, employee ID is the primary key. And it contains, and in department table, department ID is the primary key. Okay, where department table consists of two attributes, department ID and department name. Okay, just imagine that department table consists of two attributes, department ID and department name. Okay, then, and employee table consists of like all the employee information and also the department ID. Why? Because it means in which department the employee works on. Okay, so we understand by going through the employee table, we understand, okay, the employee works in which department. Maybe that primary key of the department table will be referenced here. Okay, we are using the department ID. So we are using the department table also, department ID in the employee table also. Okay, but we know that employee ID is the primary key here. Okay, but what about the department ID? Department ID, it refers to some table, right? Because we have only, by going through only the department, if you just check the employee table, we have only the department ID 1, 2, 3, 4. But what is that about? We need to find the reference to that table. If we have the department ID and we go to the department table, then we can find the relation. Okay, department ID 1 refers to the IT department. Department ID 2 refers to the finance department. Okay, so that is the referencing and the reference relation. Okay, so tuples in the referencing relation R1 have attributes FK called foreign key attributes that references the primary key attributes of the reference relation. So whatever I mentioned here, the department ID in the department ID in the employee table is the referencing relation that references the primary key attributes of the reference relation, that is the department table. So are you clear? Anyone not clear, please tell me now. Yes, department and reference table, how it is referencing and reference table.
Students, can you explain it again?
Yes, okay. Yes. See, there are two tables. Think there are two tables. I have a diagram for this one. Okay. Okay, there are two tables are there. Employee and department. Forget about this thing now. Okay. Now, what is the primary key here? Here it is the SSN. How do we tell that it is the primary key? Because there is an underline mentioned. So when there is an underline, we know that is the primary key. And in the I think there is a no relation for the department number here. Okay, just forget about this table. We have a department and department location table. I'll show you. Okay, so we have this department table and department location table. So in the department table, we have the department number as the primary key, and department location we have this okay, this is not a good example of it probably that okay just think this one, this employee table only you take. Okay, this employee table, we have this one as the SSN as the primary key, and we have a department number which is referring to some table. Okay, so we will think it is referring to the department table. So but department number here, it is the primary key, but it has been used as the referencing relation here, right? By going through it, you don't understand what is this meaning, right? Like what does this mean? What, why it will consist of some department IDs like 1, 2, 3, 4. But if now you have this table, now if you go back now to the department table, you understand, okay, that this is the name of the department. Okay, I'll explain you once more. You have in employee table, you have, this is the primary key, SSN is the primary key, and also you have one, the department ID, department number. Okay, now the employee, you, that means you know that employee works in which department, but the name of the department is not here. Okay, it is, we need to find the what, like in which department he works on, the name of the department. How will you find out? In that table, in the department table where this one is the primary key, okay, you are referencing that relation and you find the name of it. So this was the department number was the primary key in the department table, but it is used as a foreign key in the employee table. Okay, if some other's primary key is used how do I explain, let me tell you this one. If this number, SSN number, was used here without the underline symbol, that means it is the foreign key. Department number is here, okay, department number is here, but the department number belongs to which table? It belongs to the department table, okay, where it is the primary key. So by going through it, by referencing that table, then you find the department number, so department name. Now clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone, I don't know, I'm not sure about it. Give an example. See, take this diagram. In the employee table, you have SSN as the primary key. Okay, but if you want to find, and it consists of information, first name, middle name, then last name, the date of birth, address, then that is the sex, gender, salary, then super SSN and DNO. Okay, leave about the super SSN now. What the, what is this department number? That means in which department, the employees works on. Okay, we can, if we create a we are creating two different tables are there. Now this DNO, or it is a department number which is referring to some table. You have to refer to some table to understand in which department the employee works on. So this is the department table. DNO stands like it's referring to the department table where this is the primary key here. This like department number is the primary key here. Okay, and this is the department name. Now, if you this is a, so that is why this. Department number here in department table it is the primary key, but it is used in the employee table as the foreign key. Okay, understood now?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So it's written that a tuple T1 in R1 is said to be reference or tuple T2, right? Here, this is the reference to this department number. This is used, this DNO is used as a reference to D number. Next, a ref, so we have, you can just use this one, T of T1, or that is tuple 1 of foreign key equal to tuple 2 of primary key, whatever I mentioned right now, sorry. So, this is a foreign key here, this is the primary key. So both we are the same thing. DNO and D number are the same thing. Next, a referential integrity constraint can be displayed in a relational schema as directed arc. So if you want to show the relation among the table, you can show this relation as this directed arc. Okay, you are using this arrow lines. So these are known as the directed arcs. It is also known as a schema diagram. Okay, if you go when you go for database projects, you need to draw your schema diagrams. Okay. So you, if you go, you can just check this department number is a primary key. It is a foreign key. So like this. Directed arc. Again, department ID is used as a foreign key in the project table also. So directed arc. Okay. Sorry. Next, representation of relational schema and its constant. So, each relation schema can be displayed as a row of attribute names. Okay, so we can display it in the in this manner. A relation, a table is represented like you can represent it as a this one as a row of these columns, all these columns. Then. Sorry. The name of the relation is written above the attribute names. So, it is written about the attribute names. Okay. Like employee, department, department. So, you know, this is the like schema of which diagram? The last day we were discussing about the ER diagrams, right? It is the schema diagram of that one only. Same table where we had the employee relation, department relation, then we, this one project. This, the, these are the works on that dependents were there and we had the relationships and everything. Now, the primary key attributes will be underlined. A foreign key constraint, that is a referential integrity constraint, is displayed at a directed arc from the foreign key attributes to the reference table. So, you can just do it like this. The final table will look somewhat like this. Now, you check one thing. Yesterday, we discussed about the like strong entity, weak entities. I said that the weak entities do not have attributes of their own. Sorry, key attributes of their own. So you see here the in the dependent here it did not have any its own like primary key. That is why it is using the combination of ESSN and dependent name, and it is referring to, and it is the, what is this SSN? The primary key of the employee table. Okay, so it is referring. So two attributes are combined into one. In that weak relationship, we use it. Similarly, in works on relation, it is also referring to this two. What is two primary key relations are there? So you see P number and this SSN. So this is how we represent the weak entities. So by going through this diagram, you understand that department location, works on and dependent are the weak relation, okay, and others are the strong relation. See, I know it's like bit confusing, but please go through it. You will. It's very easy and like interesting. So, any confusion? Yes, students. Any confusion?
No, ma'am.
Okay, I'll share the slides. Please go through it. Okay. So, this is the final topic of the module one. Like from next class, I'll be starting module two. Okay. Just wait for some time. Let me take the attendance. Just wait. Okay.
Ma'am, can you please share the MySQL download link?
I did share yesterday. MySQL link also I'll share. Okay, I'll share that also.
Ma'am, in the official group.
Official group, okay. Or Google Classroom you want?
If you wanna send in Google Classroom, and that's okay.
Okay. See, I have sent you one video also, but I'll send you. Okay, what machine you are using, operating system? Partha?
Windows 10.
Windows 10, okay. Then it's okay. Okay, done. Thank you, everyone. Like, by the way, I have a class on Monday. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Just wait for some time. I have a class on Monday. So, will it be comfortable if I take the class at 2 o'clock? Sorry, yes, 2 o'clock. Because in that time, people are free and I have some work on 9:15. Is it possible? For you to be possible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then I'll take the class at 2, okay? Okay, then I'll take... Okay, thank you, okay, everyone. Ma'am. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.